Say hello, Dorothy. Guess what I'm most thinking about today? Ears. Yeah. You know, ears. Elmo's all ears. Whoa.
This is how I move my ears.
Oh, that's cool. Thanks, everybody. Oh, and thank you, Dorothy. Now, Elmo will ask a baby. Hello. Baby? How do you wiggle your ears, baby? Go ahead. Go ahead, baby. Oh, thank you, baby. Look, Dorothy, Elmo can wiggle his ears. Now hear this. Elmo has a question for... What's that? Elmo hears something with his ears. Well, it sounds like... Oh, it is, yes! A marching band!
I'm with the band.
Oh, that's nice. Bye-bye, bye-bye. Wow, music to Elmo's ears. Now, where was Elmo? Oh, yeah. And now, Elmo has a question.
Elmo has mail. Elmo has mail.
It's Elmo's computer.
Elmo has mail. Elmo has mail. Elmo has mail.
Elmo has mail. Elmo has mail. Stop, computer.
Elmo has mail.
Thank you. Okay, mouse. Oh, boy, it's email from Elmo's friend, the elephant.
Hi, Elmo. I love ears. I especially love songs about ears. Here's my favorite. Do your ears hang low? Do they wobble to and fro? Can you tie them in a knot? Can you tie them in a bow? Do they dangle to your toes? Can they wrap around your nose? Do your ears hang low?
a question for you. You. How many pieces of popcorn do you hear popping? We'll count them with our ears. Popcorn machine. Oh, there you are, popcorn machine. Okay.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20.
Wait, you're going too fast! Boy, but not too fast to eat. That was good. Great counting, everybody, and great listening. You can hear popcorn popping with your ears. Elmo wants to know, what else can you hear with your ears? Don't you? Let's find out. Elmo can hear the drum! Can you hear a violin?
Yes.
When someone's playing it.
La la la. La 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 la. Yeah! Can you hear a birthday cake?
No!
But you can hear people sing to you on your birthday.
Pizza, that is better. Nobody can deny.
Can you hear an ear of corn?
No!
Not unless it's popcorn! Pop, 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 pop. Can you hear a cookie?
No!
Unless Cookie Monster's eating it.
Me take that. Ha! Music to me tummy.
Thanks, Troy. Elmo's friends. Now what is Elmo hearing? Do you hear that squeaky sound? Do you think it's a mouse? Let's see. Look at that! Squeaky shoes! There you go.
Excuse us.
We can just barely squeak by here.
Sorry.
Why did we come in here anyway?
Must have taken a wrong turn at Albuquerque.
Not everyone can hear with their ears. Elmo has two friends, Alex and Emily. Emily can hear with her ears, and Alex can't. Emily told Elmo all about it.
Yesterday, I went over to my friend Alex's house to play. We played our favorite card game, Go Fish. Alex is deaf, so his ears can't hear. He looks at my lips to see what I'm saying. Go Fish. We played a few games, and then we got hungry. Alex's mom asked us what we wanted to eat. She uses sign language to talk to Alex. That's another way he finds out what someone is saying. We had bananas and milk. Alex taught me the sign for banana. And milk. And then we felt like dancing. When we dance, I listen to the music with my ears. And Alex feels the beat with his hands and feet. I bet the fish in the aquarium felt the beat too. I love playing with my friend Alex.
Emily and Alex are very good friends. But now, Elmo wants to learn more about ears. How can we find out more? Oh, yeah! We can watch the Ear Channel. Yeah. Oh, turn yourself on, TV. TV's all wavy and noisy. That's not good.
What you need is some rabbit ears. How's this?
No, still wavy and noisy.
Oh, how about this? What's this?
No.
How about this?
Oh, yeah. Oh, thanks, buddy.
Not no problem.
Welcome to the Ear Channel.
We're in one ear and out the other, so listen up. It's time for the boy who loved his dog's ears.
Once upon a time, there was a boy who loved his dog's ears.
I love my dog's ears. They're soft and furry.
And they were very useful, too. The dog used his ears for listening. He used his ears for playing peekaboo.
Peekaboo, I love my dog's ears.
He also used his ears to show his feelings. He used his ears to show when he was sad.
Bye, Louie. I have to go to school now.
Sad ears. He used his ears to show when he was happy.
I'm home, Louie.
Happy ears. He used his ears to show when he was surprised.
I have a surprise for you, Louie.
Surprised ears. He used his ears to show when he was sleepy.
Good night, Louie.
Sleepy ears. And of course he used his ears to hold up his glasses.
He did not.
Just kidding.
I love my dog's ears.
And the dog loved the boy's ears, too. The end.
Coming up next on the Ear Channel, the best ears of our lives, followed by my favorite ear.
Thanks, Bunny.
Don't mention it.
Thanks, TV. You're right. Oh, are you okay, Bunny?
You gotta get cable.
Bye. And now, Elmo wants to hear more about ears, don't you? How can we find out more?
Wanna talk to a dog-eared book?
Yeah! Does Book know a lot about doggy ears?
Sure do. Okay. And other animal ears, too. That's what I'm about. Animals and their ears.
Wow!
Yeah, take a look.
Okay. Woohoo! Yeah! Bunny! Yeah, bunnies have long ears.
Yep. And some bunnies have long ears that droop way down. See?
Yeah! Cool! Oh, look, look, Book! Dorothy's imagining Elmo as a bunny with long, droopy ears. Do your ears hang low? Do they wobble to and fro? Can you tie them in a knot? Can you tie them in a bow? Do they dangle to your toes? Can they wrap around your nose? Do your ears hang low? Whoa! Noisy carrot!
Cats have short, pointy ears, and they keep them very clean.
Meow. Still not clean. Still not clean. Still not... Bubba.
Mice have little round ears.
Squeak. Hey you! Squeak, 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 squeak. Yeah, meow. Oh, thank you, Book.
You're welcome.
Let's hear it for ears. Yay! Elmo loves ears. Oh, and so does Dorothy. That's why Dorothy wants us to sing the ear song. Here we go. Ears, 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 ears. Sing along if you want. Ears, 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 ears. Oh, say goodbye, Dorothy. Say goodbye, everybody.
Goodbye.
Yeah! to check the mail.
Right here, Dorothy? Okay.
Oh, hi! Welcome to Elmo's world! Oh, Elmo's so happy to see you! Oh, and so is Dorothy! Say hello, Dorothy! Oh, guess what Elmo's thinking about today? Whoa! What's that? Let's go and see! Come on! Oh!
It's a letter.
You don't dunk a letter.
That's not how you mail a letter. That's how you play basketball.
Try again.
Hey, where'd the basket go?
What, a wastebasket? Oh, no, Mr. Noodle.
That's a trash can. Trash can is for garbage.
You can't mail a letter that way.
You need a mailbox.
You need to find a mailbox, Mr. Noodle. Yeah, go and find a mailbox.
Yay, he found one.
Wow, he's strong.
You need to mail the letter in the mailbox. Mail it in the mail.
No!
That's under the mailbox.
You need to put it inside the mailbox.
In.
No, that's on top of the mailbox.
Not on the mailbox, in the mailbox.
Pull the handle to open it. It's in the front.
You can do it.
There's the handle.
Now put the letter in there. Put it in.
Now put it in the mailbox. Yeah!
Yeah, that's it. Put it in.
Put it...
No, you have to let go of the letter.
No, Mr. Noodle.
You need to put it inside, Mr. Noodle.
Now put it in.
Let it go.
Yay, Mr. Noodle, you did it!
Uh-oh. What's happening?
What's going on with the mailbox?
It's alive.
Oh, be careful. Mr. Noodle, what are you doing?
Oh, he's taking off.
Oh, it's airmail. Oh, Elmo gets it. Airmail.
Hold on, Mr. Noodle.
You're so silly. Yeah. Dorothy wants to ask someone else. How do you mail a letter?
This is a letter I wrote to my best friend, Max. And here's how I mail it. I open the door and I put it in the mailbox. And that's how I mail a letter, Dorothy.
Dorothy, this is how I mail a birthday card to my grandmother.
First, I put the letter in the envelope. Then I lick it closed. After that, I put the stamp on the envelope and put it in the mailbox. See, I put the flag up so the mail carrier knows there's mail inside. That's it, Dorothy.
Oh, thank you, everybody. Oh, and thank you, Dorothy. Now, Elmo will ask a baby. Oh, hello, baby. Hi. Baby, how do you mail a letter? Oh, thank you, baby. And now, Elmo has a question for you. Oh, how many stamps are in a stamp stampede? Let's count them and see. Stamps! Stamps, okay, you are.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
Oh, seven stamps. And one very big package. Yeah. Where you going, package? Wow, smart stamps. Must be special delivery. Cool, great counting, everybody. But Elmo hopes Elmo gets more mail soon. Oh, yay!
Elmo's got email.
That's another
Elmo
kind
has
of mail.
Elmo has mail.
Computer, stop. Come back, computer.
Elmo has mail.
Elmo's going to get computer.
Mail.
Computer.
Elmo has mail. Elmo has mail.
Stop that, computer.
Elmo has mail.
Good computer. Okay, mouse. Oh, Elmo's got email from his friend Big Bird.
Hi, Elmo. Say hello, Radar. I'm checking my mailbox to see if I got any mail. Oh, look. It's for you, Radar. It's a postcard. And guess who it's from? Me! And it says, Dear Radar, wish you were here. Oh, you are here. Love, Big Bird. He just loves getting mail.
Thanks for the email delivery, computer. Radar is so lucky. He got a postcard from Big Bird in the mail. What else can we get in the mail? Let's find out. Open up, drawer. Oh, that was easy. Can you get an ice cream cone in the mail?
No.
No.
It would melt.
Oh, messy. Can you get a tiger in the mail?
No.
No. But you can get a postcard from India where tigers live. Can you get a birthday cake in the mail?
No.
But you can get a birthday card. Can you get cookies in the mail?
Yes.
Cowabunga! And you get box too. I'm not for box. Me love postal service.
Thanks, Thor. Elmo loves getting mail as much as Cookie Monster. And Elmo's friend Jennifer likes sending it. Oh, she sent out her birthday invitations, and she told Elmo all about it. Oh, let's watch, Troy.
I'm having a birthday party soon. And I made my own birthday invitations to send to my friends. I put them in envelopes. I even decorated the envelopes myself. My mom helped me write the addresses of where my friends live. Then All I needed were stamps. My mom took me to the post office to buy some. We waited in line. When it was our turn, I got to pick out the kindest stamps I wanted. There are lots of different kinds. I picked the ones with flowers on them. They were really pretty. Then I put the stamps on the envelope. And then I put the invitations in the mailbox. I hope my friends get the invitations. And I really hope they can come to my party. Wait till they see the great decorations I'm making.
Oh, thanks for the invitation, Jennifer. Boy, Elmo really likes it. But now Elmo wants to find out more about mail, don't you? How can we find out more? Are you okay, TV? Yeah, Elmo knows we can watch the Mail Channel. Are you sure you're okay, TV? Okay, turn yourself on.
The Mail Channel, where you can get mail 24 hours a day. We deliver. And now on the Mail Channel, the story of a letter.
Once upon a time, yesterday, little Billy Postmeyer wrote a letter to his grandma in Toledo. And guess who that letter was? That's right, yours truly, me. And then it happened, what every letter dreams of. Little Billy put a stamp on me. That tickles. And then he mailed me.
Whoa!
My journey had begun. Inside the mailbox, there were lots of other letters and packages going to places all over the world.
I'm going to the North Pole.
I'm going to South America.
Wow.
And where are you going, Junior?
I'm going to Grandma's house.
Wow. Lucky you.
All of a sudden, the mailbox opened. Grandma, is that you?
Nah, that's the letter carrier. He's gonna take us to the post office.
Before I could say postage due, I was sorted.
Whoa!
The next thing I knew, I was on an airplane to Toledo.
Hey, I'm supposed to be going first class.
I thought I'd never get to Grandma's house. But before I could say return to sender, the plane landed in Toledo. And later, another letter carrier delivered me to Grandma's mailbox. Grandma, is that you?
A letter from Billy.
Boy, Grandma sure was glad to get me. And that's my story. Being a letter is very rewarding.
Coming up next on the Mail Channel, The Scarlet Letter, followed by Lady and the Stamp.
Oh, thanks, Stevie. Now Elmo really wants to know more about mail, don't you? But how can we find out more?
Hey! Want to talk to a mailbox?
A mailbox, yeah!
No one knows more about mail than I do. I get all kinds of mail.
Really? What kinds?
Oh, packages, magazines, letters, invitations. Oh boy, I just can't get enough. Yum, yum.
Wow. Well, what kind of mail does mailbox like best?
Junk mail! Oh, boy! You got anything to mail?
No, not right now.
Oh, that's too bad. Because if you did, you would put it right in here.
Oh, yes, Elmo sees.
And then the letter carrier would come and take it out of here. And that's one way mail gets from one place to another. Another way mail gets from one place to another is by airplane.
Oh, look, 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 mailbox. Dorothy's imagining Elmo delivering mail on a plane.
Ooh,
best. I can finally feather my nest. Thank you.
You're welcome.
And that's how mail gets from one place to another.
Thanks, Mailbox. Wow. Elmo really loves mail. Oh, and Dorothy does, too. That's why Dorothy wants us to sing the mail song.
Ooh.
Here we go.
Ooh.
Yeah. Mail, 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 mail. Sing along. Mail, 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 mail.
Oh, I love the mail song. May I sing?
Oh, sure.
Mail, 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 mail.
Pizza. Dorothy, this is how you eat spaghetti. You twist the fork, and then you pick it up and eat it. This is how you eat with chopsticks, Dorothy. You hold it like a pencil, and then you take it and eat it. See?
Thank you, Dorothy. Now, Emma will ask a baby.
Yeah.
Oh, hi, baby. Baby, how do you eat? Go ahead. Thank you, baby. Yum, yum, yum. And now, Elmo has a question for you. Yeah, you. Let's see how many hot dogs pass in front of Elmo. Let's count. Hot dog. There you are. One. One hot dog. Oh. Still one. One very long hot dog. But wait, how many baked beans?
One. Two,
time. Don't touch that dice.
And now, let us begin today's main course. The girl who loved to eat and try new foods.
Once upon a time, there was a girl who loved to eat and try new foods.
I love to eat.
And she traveled all over the world to try new and unusual foods.
Hi, what's for dinner?
She went to Italy and tried linguine with calamari.
You're gonna finish that, Marcello?
She went to India and she tried spicy vegetable curry. Some like it hot. Mmm! She went to Japan and she tried udon with chopsticks.
I love noodles.
The girl thought she had tried every food on earth, but then she heard that the Jabowski family of Brooklyn, New York, apartment 4C, ate something truly extraordinary. Smushed peanuts on bread.
Huh?
Also known as peanut butter sandwiches.
Wow, I never ate that before.
So they gave her a peanut butter sandwich to try.
Hey, it's different, but I like it. I really like it.
Then they gave her a glass of milk to go with it.
Milk? Weird.
But refreshing! And so the girl who loved to eat and try new foods continued circling the globe and ate happily ever after. The end!
Coming up on the Eating Channel, the last taco in Paris. Ciao!
Oh, now what? Elmo still wants to know more about eating food. Who could that be?
So, I'm food. You can talk to me.
Elmo knows what you are. You're an apple.
Yeah, kid. You're right. I am an apple.
Uh-huh. Well, you know what? Elmo loves apples.
Oh, kid, you got good taste. Let me tell you about myself. First of all, I'm a kind of fruit. And I'm red, see?
Oh, and Elmo's red, too, see?
Oh, yeah. And look, I got this little stem up on my top.
Right there.
Yeah.
That's pretty.
And inside of me, I got a core. Oh, an apple core.
Oh, very cool.
And did I mention I was red?
Yes, and so is Elmo. Look.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, what about us?
We're food, too.
I'm a peanut butter and jelly sandwich.
Yum.
Thank you.
I'm corn.
I'm broccoli.
We're vegetables.
Ah, delicious.
And I'm a pizza.
Oh, Elmo loves pizza.
Not only do all these foods taste good, but they're good for you, too. They help you to be healthy and strong.
Food for thought. Oh, Apple? Where can Elmo get food besides his closet?
Well, you can get the pizza at a pizza parlor.
Ah. Oh, look. Dorothy's imagining Elmo in a pizza parlor making a pizza. Elmo loves this part. Supposed to come down.
While we're waiting, I'll tell you where you can get me an apple off a tree.
Oh, yeah. Elmo picked an apple. Pizza!
And sometimes after we're picked, we're sent to grocery stores. Oh, you can buy us and all kinds of food.
Oh, look! There's bread, grape jelly, peanut butter. Oh, there's apples. Elmo will buy an apple. Yeah. Elmo's glad he didn't pick a watermelon. Yeah. TV. This is Elmo's breakfast before he ate it. Okay, now put it down. That's good.
Something in the sky, Mr. Noodle.
They're not in the sky. Cars are on the ground.
Yeah, see, that's the ground.
Keep trying.
That's a surfboard.
A surfboard? No way.
Hey, Tim, Mr. Noodle. Wow, that looks like fun.
What is something in the sky?
Surfboards are in the water, not in the sky.
Try to think of something you see when you look up in the sky.
A kite?
Oh.
Kite.
Yeah, a kite's in the sky.
Oh, but it's not in the sky now.
Throw it up and run, Mr. Noodle. Throw the kite in the air.
You can do it, Mr. Noodle. Almost.
You need the wind to fly the kite.
You need wind like this.
Now fly the kite.
Wow, that's windy. Now fly the kite.
There it goes.
Yay, Mr. Noodle.
Mr. Noodle is flying a kite in the sky. Yay!
Oh, no, the wind's too strong.
Now Mr. Noodle's up in the sky, too.
Hold on, Mr. Noodle.
Thanks, Shay. Dorothy wants to ask someone else. What do you see when you look up in the sky?
Hi, Dorothy. This is a picture I made. I made a sky and a sun. I made the sun yellow, and when I look up at the sun, it's like a golden yellowish. And I mix some blue for the sky because that's how the sky looks sometimes.
Hi, Dorothy. This is a picture of a plane, and it's in the sky, really high. And there's a sun, and there's clouds. Do you like it?
Hi, Dorothy. This is a picture that I drew. There's a shooting star, another star, and these are all planets. They're in the sky at night. What do you think?
Oh, thanks, everybody. Oh, and thanks, Dorothy. Now, Irma will ask a baby. Oh, hello, baby. Hello. Baby, what do you see when you look up in the sky? Oh, a bird. Oh, thank you, baby. Bye. Oh, boy. And now...
Elmo has mail.
Elmo has mail. That's better. Oh, no. And a computer mouse doesn't fly in the sky either. Thanks, mouse. Let's see who sent Elmo an email. Oh, it's from Humphrey and Ingrid. Hello, Elmo.
Yes, and let me be the first to say, hello, Elmo.
You know, there's something else that you can see when you look up in the sky.
Yes, something near and dear to our furry little hearts.
Yeah. Look, what? Up in the sky.
Is it a diaper?
Is it a blankie?
No, it's Super Baby. Flying high in the sky. Hello there, you little super pookie. Isn't she the cutest thing you've ever seen?
In the sky? Goodbye, Elmo.
And might I add, goodbye, Elmo.
Thanks, Humphrey and Ingrid. Thanks, Computer Helicopter. And now... Elmo has a question for you. Yeah, you. How many birds are flying in the sky? Let's count them and see.
One, two,
three,
four,
five,
six,
seven,
eight,
nine,
ten,
11,
12.
Oh, 12. 12 birds flying in the sky. Oh, and a kangaroo. Well, wait a minute. Kangaroos can't fly in the sky. Oh. Oh. But they sure do bounce. Oh, silly kangaroo. That makes Elmo wonder. What else can you see when you look up in the sky? Oh, maybe the drawer knows. Drawer! Drawer! Oh, there you are! Come on, open up, drawer! Oh, come on, don't be shy. Please open up. That's it. A little more. A little more. Oh! What can you see when you look up in the sky? A cloud? An elephant or a mailbox?
A cloud.
Yeah, a cloud. Now, what else? A birthday cake? A rocket? Or a bunny rabbit?
A rocket.
Right, a rocket. What about a turtle, a rock, or a worm?
None of them are in the sky.
They're all on the ground.
Unless the worm is Slimy flying in his airplane.
Go, Slimy.
Yay, Slimy. Oh, look! Mr. Noodle is still up in the sky. Oh, hang in there, Mr. Noodle.
Tweet, 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 tweet. Tweet. Tweet, tweet.
Boy, you can see some amazing things when you look up in the sky. Elmo's friend, Cheryl Lynn, likes to look up in the sky with her mommy. And she told Elmo all about it. The other day, Cheryl Lynn and her mommy went outside to look up in the sky. It was great. They saw birds. Airplanes. Wow. A blimp. The sun. And lots of kites. Wow, the kites were pretty. But while they were looking up in the sky, they almost got wet. They also saw clouds. Clouds are Cheryl's favorite. If you use your imagination, clouds can look like all sorts of things. Cheryl thought that one looked like a face. And she thought that would look like a cauliflower. And at the end of the day, when the sun went down, they watched it together. It was really pretty. That was when they knew it was almost time for bed. So they went back home. Bye-bye, Cheryl and her mommy. Wow. There's lots of pretty things to see when you look up in the sky. But Elmo wants to know more about the sky, don't you? How can we find out more? Oh, yeah, we can watch the Sky Channel! Thank you, TV. Turn yourself on.
Welcome to the Sky Channel, your eye in the sky. And now for your in-flight entertainment, the little penguin who tried to fly in the sky.
Once upon a time, there was a little penguin who tried to fly in the sky like other birds. He flapped his wings, but that didn't work. He jumped in the air, but that didn't work. He even tried getting a running start. That didn't work either. His little penguin body wasn't made to get off the ground. That's penguin for, I'm going to fly if it's the last thing I do. Which is penguin for, you're full of hot air. Eureka! He was flying in the sky in a hot air balloon. He was full of hot air. Soon, all the other penguins took to the sky, too. They flew in airplanes, in helicopters, in blimps, even hang gliders. Anything that was made to fly in the sky. And the little penguin lived happily ever after. In the sky, of course. That's penguin for, the sky's the limit. The end.
Coming up next on the Sky Channel, the
the sky who loved me.
Wait, Chibi! Elmo still wants to learn more about the sky. Well, how can we find out more? Oh, okay, Dora, open up.
Maybe I can shed some light on the subject.
Wow, it's the sun! Oh, the sun is bright.
I sure am. I am the brightest thing you will see in the sky. I shine and light everything up.
Boy, the sun does a great job, too.
Thank you. And when I set, it gets dark. It becomes night, and you can't see me anymore.
But you can see me, the moon.
Oh, yeah! Elmo loves to see the moon in the sky at night.
Thanks, Elmo. Sometimes you can even see me in the daytime sky.
That's right.
Oh, yeah! The moon looks pretty in the sky, day or night.
Oh, go on.
Oh, look. Dorothy's imagining the moon in the sky and Elmo's on it. Elmo's gonna dance on the moon.
Sometimes you can see a rainbow in the sky, but only during the day.
Comfy!
At night, if you look up in the sky, you might also see stars. And sometimes a group of stars can make a picture called a constellation. You just have to connect the dots.
Yeah, Elmo's a constellation! Oh, and thank you, Sun and Moon.
No sweat.
Boy, Elmo loves the sky. Oh, and so does Dorothy. That's why Dorothy wants us to sing the sky song.
Hey, can we sing too?
Oh, sure. And you can sing along with us. Here we go. Do-do-do. Sky, sky, sky. Sky, sky, sky. Sky, 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 sky. Everybody!
Sky, 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 sky,
sky, sky,
sky, sky, sky,
sky, sky, sky, sky, sky, sky, sky, sky, sky, sky, sky, sky,
good night.
Bye.
Bye.